Test, 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 test.
Good afternoon, I'm Peter Brackley and welcome to the game. And as the fans make themselves heard around the stadium,
test,
is with me.
Thanks, Peter. I was chatting to some of the fans earlier and they're all looking forward to this one.
You really can sense there's plenty of passion here between the two sets of players. So let's hope both teams will thrill us with an excellent display of football today.
Okay, so again, welcome. If you're just watching this now, or you're watching this as a video in the future, again, I am Wildcat48. I'm the one who made Wildcat Athletic Club, the channel. And I said in a video recently that I would start streaming, or I would look to start streaming. And so I am bringing that to fruition with starting with this. So, a game that I've played a lot recently is PES 6, and so that is the game I've decided to start my first stream with, and I am going to start by trying to play through one of the cup competitions. I'm going to lower the sound down just a tad for me. Do tell me if it is difficult to hear me in the chat. I have the chat open, so I should see it. And it should work. So again, if you are watching, just send a message through the chat to let me know if that's working, if everything is sounding okie dokie. But yeah, so I wanted to go through a cup competition tonight and try to finish one of those. So currently, if we look through my museum cup gallery, I haven't played through any of the cups, so I'm gonna try to, at least I've won the Division 2 cup, and it says I've won all of these, but I haven't actually. I think that's just because of the season update that I have. So we're gonna try playing through one of the cups. I thought about doing one of the shorter ones. Let's see what they have available. I don't really have like a... like the FA Cup. We could do the Copa America. Professional level, I think. We'll try on professional since it's been a bit since I played. I played a lot, but I haven't played much recently. So we'll go from that and see how it goes. Again, this is my first attempt, so at turning a full stream, so please do let me know if it sounds poor. And I'll try to work on that as we go through. Let's add some stadium effects. I'll do the Copa America. And then... so, if we look at the teams available, I think I will... I don't want to do the big teams. I think Argentina and Brazil obviously would be really good. Mexico would be interesting. United States would be interesting. Uruguay would be interesting. I think I'll play with the United States for this one. So, okay, so I can put them anywhere. So we'll just do it random for the rest of them. Not give us any advantage. Get right into it and see if we can win the Copa America. Okay, let's see who the United States have on their team at the time. So, For anyone wondering about the rosters, I am using a updated roster for the 2006-07 season. So this would be the hypothetical 2006 Copa America. I don't even know if they had a Copa America during that year, but we'll go with what team we have. So we have Keller here, Tim Howard. I'll put Howard in goal because he is younger and I think he would be better form-wise. He is form-wise better than him too. Reyna is old too. Beasley is only 24 at the time. Jesus, it's funny to think that he's only 24 at the time. Greg Berhalter, who is the current national team manager, is there as well. Clint Dempsey is 23. Looks like they're playing a 4-4-1-1 or like a 4-5-1 formation. So we're going to stick with that. I'm not going to do too many changes. Go ahead and save it. See how we do. Again, if you are watching, please do let me know if the chat's working. I haven't had anyone send chats yet, so if anyone would like to, that'd be awesome to see if it's working. But yeah, so we're going to start the stream with going against Colombia in the Copa America, see if we can get a good win here. It is on professional difficulty. Top player is the highest at this specific game, so we'll see. They do have Radamel Falcao. I believe that's Falcao, a young one. Murillo is the other name I know there. That's about it for that team. So, we'll see. See how we do. Let's get right into it. So you probably will hear my controller noise while I'm doing this. So apologies for that. I guess it'll be kind of an old school style. Okay. Well, that's a good ball. Wouldn't even mattered. One of them was already off. Okay. Let's be smart here. Good. Good idea. Easily play through into Donovan. Get into McBride. That's something I haven't quite figured out. If you've played PES 6, so if you do, then please let me know. How to do lofted through walls? I haven't quite figured that out, because that would have been perfect for Landon Donovan to get on the ball there. Oh! Good Tim Howard. Okay. Out to Poncanerica. Okay. We're doing okay. It's interesting that it has the Champions League style motif.
Down the line.
Okay. Here we go. Just trying to work the ball forward. The crossing. I think a good corner kick. Oh. Bloody hell, Arena is slow. He is 33 years old, so it makes sense. Okay, Negra. Out. Good. Through. Good. Boca Negra. Plans. I was playing that to the striker, but that's okay. Right. Okay, just stay front, stay front, stay front, stay front. Nice. Pause it real quick. Okay, let's get back into it. Oh, that's a shot on target. Not bad, not bad, not bad. Stay front, stay front. Stay front, stay front. No foul, no foul, no foul. Good. There. Clear, clear, clear. Good save by Tim Howard. Go. Through to Beasley. Oh, he has all that space. Come on, come on. Ha. Trying to get that touch back because it's just, you tap it, it goes sky high. Front, stay front. Stay front, stay front. Good. Good. Okay, so I don't think we had all but one shot in that first half. So not... Yeah, I nearly had it that time. Yeah, so at least the chat's working. I can see it. Perfect. Don't know how delayed it is, but... I am If you are watching, I am in the white. I'm playing with the white team. The Colombia is in the blue. Come on, play it. Here we go. Boom. Okay. Safe front, safe front. The biggest issue I have playing these PES games is typically is just scoring. So I can defend decently. It's the scoring part in these older PES titles. Okay. Play it in. Go. That's easy about the keeper.
Can he keep it going? Gets it in space. Bad tackle there.
Ah, that's not a foul. Another opportunity for a cross. Keeps up like this, I might try putting Dempsey in for McBride. Just so we can switch up the pattern of play a little bit.
Good pass. Poor ball picked off.
Oh! That was the right idea. Just, it was a hard ball to hit across the entire length of the field. Because he's on the left side, he's on the right side to play that through ball. No, no. It's not the 60th minute, but... see if we can put Albright in. Come on, lad, come on, lad, come on. Safe run. Goodbye, Falcao, but we did well too. Bring on Albright for Bocanegra. I don't know. It's hard to tell. Some of these names are so uncommon that I don't know. Like, Turundolo, I don't think was an actual United States men's national team player. That's just because I don't actually remember the team back then because I wasn't watching soccer at the time, so. It's harder to attack, Jude, because defensively, all you have to do is basically get the ball out, but it's the shooting touch that I lack. As I get a decent shot there, it's a shooting touch. A lot of the older PEZs, PEZ 5, PEZ 6, PEZ 2, PEZ 3, all of them have it to where if you hit shoot, you would expect, well, if I hold it down just a little bit, it'll be maybe 3/4 the bar. But if you hold it down maybe a second, it becomes a full bar. Compared to the older, the newer FIFAs, where the power bar is, you have to hold that thing down a lot to be able to get the amount of power from just a tap would be in PES. Oh, that's not a foul. They bring on a triple sub. Yeah, we'll do the same. We'll bring on Dempsey, and then let's bring on Eddie Johnson for Yeah, with Breon Lewis. And then, no, actually, like, I guess it's done. Those two. Do those two. Try that and go from there. Safe front, safe front. Oh! Clear that. Safe front. Good, he's offsides. Okay. He might be going into PKs at this rate. And over to, well, extra time too. Yeah, we've only had 4 shots, 2 on target. Which, expected as much, honestly. Like I said, US is not a powerhouse, especially back then. They have much more skilled players now compared to then. Stay in. Ah. Force them to make the mistake. That's the best we can do with this type of team. We can't be the ones to make the mistake. Oh, bloody hell. No. Hit the post. Click, clicker. Clear the bloody ball. Thank you. Jeez. There we go. Okay. Come on, I need someone to run ahead of me. And he runs ahead. That's okay. It's just their team has not really any pace. You get a ball in the box, so not bad. Not bad. Just take it one at a time. Okay. Oh, I wanted that to go to Covey on the right. There we go. Well, it's Lewis. I forgot. It's what. Stop Covey out. Go, Lewis, go! Go! Run on set. Shoo! Close. Is anyone tired enough where we need some combi? Oh, I already did it on myself, that's why I was doing that. Okay. Here we go. Simple save. Okay. It's behind him. Tiredness is affecting us at this point. Okay. Okay, come on, come on, come on, come on. Good. Play it through. Good. The Dempsey. He has no one with them. Come on. Lewis can't get up. Lewis cannot get past anyone. He has the pace of not anyone decent enough. He's not having Bobby pace, that's for sure. Okay. Okay, well, eventful first game, I guess, ever for streaming, so let's see if we can... Oh, I think it went off the goalie end. Okay. Or is it the left stick that does PKs? Yep, it is. Okay, I was right. Okay. Alrighty, okay. You go bottom left this one. Nice. Come on. Come on, let's stop Mario's shot. I went right side, but it was up above me. Okay. That was close. Okay, next one, next one. Let's see what we can do. Benno? Good, good save. Come on, Lewis. Good. We just gotta stop one more, and we win. Looking left. And he went right. Okay. Okie dokie. Maceroni. How did he miss that? Oh. I even went the right way and everything. Okay. Let's go middle this time. Good. Good. Left. How'd I miss that one? Can he be the hero? Damn it. That's decided the game. They can't do any better than the quarterfinals. Damn it. Well, with a team like the United States, that would be a very hard cup to win. So, considering what we did, that's not too bad. Yes, it did, didn't it? Yeah, I went everywhere but the goal. Okay, so... Viewers, what should we do next? Should we do... Just a regular one-off match? To try another league match? Or a cup match? Another cup run? What should we do? Grand selection match might be fun too. So those are the three options. Which one should we do? I'll give it like 10 seconds or 30 seconds to see. Because if we did a random selection match, it basically means that it'll randomly select players from specified criteria, which the newer PEZs brought it back. PEZ 18 is the first one that had it again. If we did another cup match, it would probably be like the World Cup or the Euros. If we did just a random match, I would just do any teams. Random selection, match, or cups. I think I'll just do a regular match then. Let's just do something simple. Let's do I think Bayern's in here, right? Yep. Let's do Bayern Munich versus Man United, and we'll play as Bayern. Professional. You know, let's try regular. I want to actually score a goal. Let's try regular. Let's do an entrance scene. Make it somewhere like a Champions League final. And then let's have it be Camp Nou. And let's make it night. Classic ball. Yep, there we go. Man, Oliver Kahn is still playing. Bastian Schweinsteiger, Mackay. When on Graves hadn't transitioned. Or he hadn't been sold to United yet. I think he ends up getting sold in a couple seasons. And Michaelis is there. Matt Hummels. Yeah, let's do that. Let's just play their normal lineup. See what we can do. Recreation of the 99 finals, but this time I'm going to play as Bayern Munich and see what we can do. Not a full recreation because it is in the 06-07 season, but not bad enough. Okay, Oliver Kahn is still there, probably the only player that is left from that team. Okay. The ball to everyone. Just get used to moving around the pitch. Okay. Good. Shot! Ooh! Goal! There we go. I spent all that time with the United States trying to beat Colombia in the Copa America in the first round, and it takes me 1 second with Bayern Munich to break through, but I did lower the difficulty one, so. As expected. Not a bad goal. Not a bad goal at all. But there we go. Play inside. Get up top again. Zadro into. Nemanovic. That's how you say it. Ryan Leogan. There we go. Come on. Come on. Where is our midfield? Forward. There we go. Inside. Get to it. Close. Second. There we go. I'm off the ball. Ronaldo is one of the cheat codes in this game. Adriano is the biggest cheat code from what I've seen. So you think he has 99 shot power. No one to play that ball. Oh, that was there. It was there. Mbamu. Cross. Header. Cleared away. Okay, good. Mbamu. Rosaldo. Play through. Side pass. That is a weak pass. Okay. Get on it. There we go. Sagno. That's a foul. Thank you. One second. Okay. Let's keep at it. Let's do the kick. Header. See, I never get those right. I always feel like they're not doing what they should be doing, you know? It should be right in that middle gap between their line and the goalkeeper, but it always feels like there's never a player in that position, for the most part, for it to actually work and be anything. You know. Ooh, close. It's close. Boyden. Blom. Bommel. Okay. See, Svensson. Got the ball anyways. Here we go. Play through. I couldn't get away. It's the 45 degree turns that messed me up. Okay, signal. Safe front. Good. Come on, Bizarro, get in the space. Unlucky, it should have been at least a corner out of that. You know, for just being one difficulty down, it's still really tough. We didn't even get a shot on target. That's why if you do watch our PES 6 series with United, just the sheer difficulty we've had scoring has been immense. Let's see if we can score this real quick. Oh, not bad. It's a corner. So most of the time, defensively, we're really good. It's just the offensive portion is just lackluster. Good attempt. Okay. Sometimes the passing animations are so funny. He took a full second to just sit there and just admire them coming at him. Okay, Oliver Kahn, the 37-year-old. I say 37 when probably doesn't age with the amount of passion he provides. That shot was our best shot so far of the stream, for sure. It is our first goal we scored in the stream, so it fits. This is about how it went in real life, though. Bayern Munich, I don't remember what minute they scored in the 99 final, but they scored first, and then obviously they scored first. And then United came back and scored two, and that was up. It's gonna be the goalies. Unfortunate. Foul. Easy. I think that's Carrick, yeah. What's nice about having this season update for the game, besides the fact that it gives all the One second. Corner. Besides that fact that it gives all the teams their correct branding. It's a good header. It also gives the correct rosters and everything for the time, which for me is just as important as having the opportunity to have all the correct logos and realism of that, and stadiums too. Just because for me, I didn't watch football or know much about football at the time, so it's kind of interesting to see how these teams have evolved. 'Cause this season is 18 years old now, so it's just interesting seeing it change. And fun. It really is fun. I went to a retro store, retro game store about it was yesterday. Duh, it was yesterday. And I actually got Winning 11-7, which is the States version of PES 3, basically. Yeah, PES 3. And it's funny seeing that game compared to this, which this came out only 4 years later, and it's night and day difference in gameplay. And even I have PES. Second shot. I have PES 2, which is Winning 11-6. And if you were playing those games at the time, which if you do end up coming around this stream or this video later on, please do tell me what you think of that and what you thought of playing those games, because back to back, because for me, playing them now, it's a night and day difference how much better has. Oh, a shot! A chance! There we go! Goal! Lazo! It's just a night and day difference how PES 6 to 7, or sorry, Winning 11 6 to 7 is. 6 is a lot more clunky. You can't really dribble with the ball that much. You have to pass it a lot just because the ball bobbles up too much. 7 does the kind of same thing, but the visuals are sharper, the control is a little better, so it doesn't feel as bad. And it's more enjoyable experience, it's more modern. I read a comment because I was watching Winning 11 6 and 7 gameplay, and there's a comment saying how Winning 11. Let's get out real quick. Good. Winning 11-7 was a modernization, was the first one that was clearly modernized for the PS2. And it shows with both those versions back to back to each other. I can definitely see that. pass. Come on. Come on, come on. Ah, good save by Van der Sar. They brought off. Oh, so they're going a three back. I saw that, right? Right? Yeah. So that's interesting because, like, correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't think many, when you play FIFA, modern FIFA, I don't think they change the formation. Like, I haven't really ever seen a team besides in PES, even, like the new PES 21, I'm fairly sure they always change the formation when they're down behind in a game. Or at least they change the setting. So if you've played PES 21, then you know this. If you're behind in a game, you put it on all out attack, it moves one of your center backs up into the forward position as another center forward. So I would assume that's what it does, but I've never seen them actually change the formation like they just did here by switching to a three back. So what they do, they switch to a three back, so it's Evra, Neville, and Ferdinand back, and then Larsson up top with Rooney and Zaha. Okay, so we need to watch that. I don't think I'm going to change for my formation. I think we could manage it, especially up 2-0, as we almost go down with that back heel on the from bloody box. Okay, but they're going to be so vulnerable on the counter. Come on, come on, come on. I need someone to move. There we go. Ah, why did you go back inside, Pizarro? Okay. Just stay front, stay front. There we go. Like I said, they're going to be so vulnerable on the counter. That's a goal. Oh, what a save by Van der Sar. There is a mod I want to download for, I think it's for PES 6, that has all the retro World Cup rosters. I think it'd be really fun to play through that and play through the teams that got to the final but didn't win it, and then see if we can get to that final and try to win it. I think they have the same for the Champions Leagues. It might be the Champions Leagues or the World Cups, but either way, I'd like to try that. I think it'd be fun. Oh, do get a late goal by Luis Saha, but I think we should be okay. Come on, let's play smart. There we go. Good. Not bad, not bad, not bad. Let's do a random selection match. Let's try that out. Let's try that out, shall we? So let's select a... So you can select a team, or you can select an area. Let's select all the Premier League, and then let's do basically a Premier League versus Bundesliga, because I don't know much about Bundesliga, so that'd be fun and interesting. So I got Steve Given as my goalkeeper. Keane, I have no idea what team he plays for. Alberto Silva, he plays for Arsenal, I believe. We got Ronaldo and Zaha. Okay, we got Ronaldo and Zaha. And then Amiobi. Okay. That's interesting, at least. Jesus, they have Hummels as their starting center back at 18. Okay. Let's do a random. Let's do a day game, actually. Do a day game. Do a day game in Highbury, since it is home for a Premier League team. At least at the time it was. Let's do summer, like a friendly. Make it fine. We'll do it on PKs just in case it goes to PKs. Regular goalie seems better, so we'll do that. Let's change the ball to, we'll do that one. And let's just, and we'll set it to random. Change the frames to, exhibition. We'll just do exhibition. Okay. We're not going to change a bit. We're just going to play with that team and see how it does against their team. Pixelation on those kits is so funny. Okay.
And it's a long awaited afternoon's football, and I'm very much looking forward to it. The players are on their way out, so before we start, a few words from Trevor.
Thanks, Peter. Everyone seems ready for kickoff, so let's join the action.
Even though this is just an exhibition match, both sides are filled with some fierce.
Okay.
The game kicks off, a great match expected here.
Petrov. Hilib, Sandin, Inchov, okay. Ah, Zaha. He's a player I play with a lot because of United. Nkrumah, it is kind of, these kits do not fit well on the radar on the bottom. I'm sorry, I didn't see the message about picking random, but we are doing random now, so if you do see the video, then you're welcome to see the random match now. So apologies for that. I don't have, I'm still trying to test out, so if this shows how jank my setup is right now, all my chat is on my phone. Oh, what a miss. So, some messages I may miss. I'm trying not to, but it's difficult sometimes. Ronaldo, 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 Ronaldo. Cut it back, cut it back. It's behind him. He's so good as a center forward as well, Ronaldo, in this game. Petrov. Inside. Adam. I don't know what that was, but got the ball back at least. Not bad. That ain't going anywhere. Okay. Nope. I do like the idea of creating kind of a retro stream, so doing retro stream sounds like PlayStation sound or whatever it may be for this type of old school stuff, because I like retro stuff a lot and I like playing retro games. It's funny to think that this is a retro game. Hell, probably PES 15 would be a retro PES now. FIFA 15, which was the first FIFA I ever played. Here we go. Open it. He's off. I think it'd be fun if I'd made a all-star team on here. Like a fair players at the time type of thing. Well, let's see. Let's see. Okay. Yes. That is poor. Okay. Come on. Come on. Gammon, gammon, gammon. What's interesting about older sports games versus newer ones, and you'll see it a lot with like the Madden series, how some innovations are still present in these older ones and aren't present in the newer ones. I still, why I go back and I play these older games is one for the time capsule experience, first and foremost, I think. Even if the gameplay is not perfect and is very janky and old, I still will try them because for me, it's what was it like to play at a time where this was the best game available? Because at one point, if you were living in 2005 and if I was 18 in 2005 and I loved playing football matches virtually, this was the best opportunity. Whew! How did that jump back to him? How did that get back to Makai? One second. Sorry. I'll get on my spiel soon. But how did that bloody ball get back to Makai? Did it bounce? I think it bounced underneath the goalie. Okay, it bounced, hit his chest, went up, and then he headed it through. Okay, I see that now. Okay. Anyways, as I was saying, it's that experience of playing these when they were the best games around. Truthfully, some are still. I enjoy them playing. Ah, that was my chance. I enjoyed them playing them. Oh, hello. Hello there, Trumbull. Nice to see you too. But yeah, so I enjoy playing these games now because some are better. And yeah, so if you're just joining, and you're wondering what this is Pro Evolution Soccer 6. For the 2006-2007 season. So thank you for joining. And I'm just playing a random game with random selection players. I'll explain what it is when we get out of it. But yeah. So yeah, like I was saying, a lot of these older games are fun for me because one, the time capsule experience, and then two, at the same time, a lot of them, their gameplay is so different that they're a good challenge for me, and they're enjoyable to play. Whereas it gets very samey. Even though decent chance by Gilberto Silva. It gets very samey playing PES 21 over and over again, even though it is probably one of the best PESs in the lineup, it still gets very samey. But yes, so what this is. So basically what this is you get to pick a random selection, so if you're playing Madden, you just get to pick offsides. I get to pick a random player, so if I wanted to be a random selection to AFC versus NFC players, it'd be the same thing like that. So what I did is a random selection of the English Premier League versus a random selection of the German League, and that's what I got. And we're the team in gray, and we're the ones that are down. But yeah, so that's kind of something that clear. Okay. That's something I would like to do, is to play all these old games. And I have all these old games in my catalog. I want to play them. I'm trying to find a reason to play them, and I think streaming would be fun to do with that. Playing FIFA 01 through all the way to FC 24 in a career mode of some nature. I see videos on it all the time, but it's just, I don't really have the passion to make that into a video series first. I like the idea of talking with people, sharing the experiences of these older games, and then possibly making a video of it in the future. That's not going anywhere. But you know, just go with the flow and see how it goes. Oh, hey, Andrew, how are you? Nice to see you. I know you had talked about seeing me start streaming, and yep, this is the first one you're in for it. Okay. Let's see if we can get it here. Okay. Stay front. Oof, good save by Gibbon. One second. Yeah, so Nathan, I was thinking of doing one team for that, like FIFA 1 to FC 24 career mode all the way. So, like say I would do with Manchester United, and I would make sure all the transfers that happen in those career modes stick true and go through. So it would be a little bit of work, but I'd have you guys to talk to, so it'd make it a little bit... Ronaldo! Decent opportunity. I'd make it a little more worth it, because I'd have someone to chat with along the way. But yeah, I think that'd be really fun to do, and see how different the role gets. I know there isn't a eras mode in any game, any football game, like there is in 2K, but I think it'd be really fun to try that out and see how it goes, you know? And do tell me, guys, this is my first stream too, so since there's a couple more of you here, do tell me in the chat if it sounds alright. If the audio mix isn't quite right, let me know, because I can change that pretty quickly, pretty easily. But we're getting late into the game, and we're not doing well, so I'm going to try to switch. God, Johansson's in terrible form. Let's take off Sinan and put in Mbouba Diop. I don't know him. I don't want to take off Ronaldo, though. I might take him off, though, and we'll move him to cam so we get more runs through, you know? Gilberto Silva's done alright. Actually, we'll take off Petrov because I think he's fairly slow. We'll bring on Emiobi, which I think he's decently quick. And then I don't think I have a side back, but I know Mascherano can play side back, so put him there. Yep. Thank you, Nathan. That's good to know. That was my worry with the stream, and if you guys look back through the footage and it looks kind of janky, that is the main reason. The sound quality, it makes me janky. And then the picture quality sometimes will kind of stutter a little bit, but that's just because it's an old game and it struggles at times. Okay, there we go. Is that all the changes I want to make? I think so. There we go. 11. Get there first. Lost my chance. I need to just take shots. Yeah, Andrew, I was talking about that with some of my friends about whether I was going to do it on Twitch or if I was going to do it on YouTube, and I think I wanted to do it on YouTube at least to start out with to see how it runs, because for me, clear the bloody ball. For me, I know that all you guys are on YouTube, and I figured it'd be much easier to see if it's just right there. And at the same time, I wanted to do it on YouTube because I know it saves the video clips. So if I decide to go back and say, hey, I really liked what we did in that stream and I want to make it into a video, I can just do that. So that was the idea. And we'll still see how it goes. It is my first one, so we will do our best. But we need to get this ball up the field and try to get an opportunity. That's a foul. I'll take that. But yeah. It's reasonable, just a little to the right. Okay, we're going to transition for an extra time. It's about over, unless I get this ball back here. I think it's basically, basically done. So, I am keeping track of my score, or like, my record today, so I did lose a game on penalties before the last one, which was in the Copa America. I tried playing the Copa America. So that was USA versus Colombia. This was a random selection match, so I just did a random one. I haven't played anything else. I'm not going to play the career mode, the PES 6 career mode on here right now. Because I want to save that. I don't want to gather footage for it because I don't know how the video quality is going to be. So right now I'm just playing through random games. So if any of you guys have teams that you'd like to see or countries, let me know. And I will play those games and we'll talk about them and just have a good time here, really. And relax. Yeah, so let's go ahead and I do need to send a message to someone, so one second. But yeah, so we played three games. We've won one, lost two. This was a random selection match. And then I've tried doing the Copa America at the beginning of the stream. It didn't really go well. I was my first game back to PES 6 after a bit, so it was kind of rough. It ended up being just a nil-nil at the very end, and then it was like a 5-7 or 5-6 on PKs. But yeah, I do have other PESs, so I thought we could play one more game on this and then maybe transition to like another FIFA or something, but yeah, it's really whatever you guys like, I probably have available to play, even other sports games like Madden and NBA 2K and NFL 2K. So, yes, so let's see here. Yeah, if any of you guys have any ideas of what teams you'd like to see, just let me know. Kind of curious to see. We look through the teams here. If I don't see a message, I'll probably do. We'll just do the. Let's do an international match, because I haven't done many of those on these older games. Let's do, what was the 06 final? Was that? That would have been That's the 121s. Let's do Germany or to France versus Italy. France versus Italy. Okay. Let's not do an entrance scene and let's go from there. So, France versus Italy. It did not give me a good form day, did it? Everyone's out of form. I didn't know Silvestri was French. Trezeguet, out of form too. Let's just try it. So this one is, pause it, so I can keep track of my record. France versus Italia. Okay, let's see how you do. Go do Zidane. It's a good do. Shot. Let's go. Let's see if we can do something in this match. Maybe score a goal. I didn't manage to do last match. Go. Let's get it in line. Good. Luda. Into Zidane. Hey, Henri. Just play it back. There we go. Gonna go to me, then Zidane. Henri. I haven't quite got it down. Yeah, that's true. The greatest French teams ever, for sure, Andrew. For sure. Yeah, if you look at this team, it's pretty amazing. You have Makélélé, you have Vieira, Ribéry, Malouda, Zidane, Henri, and then on the bench you have Trezeguet. It's like Zaha is a decent striker. Silvestri is a good rotation player. I think I remember with Thuram. Barthez is also a really good goalkeeper. Abadal, just amazing all around. Okay, there we go. Yeah, what was I saying? Oh, yes. I don't remember now. It's okay. And Ribéry. It's on target. Because I know at least with the stream setup I have right now, I can't see it, but for you guys, can you see your comments on the... Close. Can you see your comments on the stream when you're watching it? Sorry, 1 second. I got a message. Okay. Clear. Good. So if you send a message, can you see it? It should be in the bottom left corner of the stream. Can you see it when you send any messages? You guys? Yeah, if I can't score a goal with this team... I don't know if I can score a goal at all on Pez 5 to Pez 6 tonight. Okay, super. Thank you. That's awesome. This is working correctly. Yeah, I don't know if you were in here when I was talking about it, Andrew, but I kind of have a jank set up right now in that I couldn't get my second monitor to work correctly so I could have the chat on the left side and see the stream on the left side. So right now I just have it on my phone. So I can see chat on my phone with a delay, but it's better than nothing, I guess. At least I can actually see what you guys are saying. I need support. Go. It's just so hard to move the ball the way I want to right now. Within a second, these players are on me. Okay, let's switch it. Here we go. Davidel. Easy save by Buffon. They must be wondering what they have to do to beat this goalkeeper today. And Gattuso. But even this Italian team is so good as well. Totti. Gattuso. Like, why are you not... Sometimes it's just hard to get used to the fact that they don't really move the way I want them to, you know? And Pirlo as well, bloody hell. That team is amazing. Okay. So I think our best bet... Like, I was trying to play in Zidane, and it's just the joystick didn't agree with me. He said, no, you're not trying to pass that way. Nothing too strong so far for France. Not bad though, not bad though. I think after this game I'm gonna hop out of this chair real quick and go get a water, because talking is making me parched, but... Oh, no, 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 no! Oh, off the post. I've had it hit the post 3 times. Yeah, Andrew, did you watch that match live in 2006? Because the way it sounds like you are. You said the way it sounds, if I can use words correctly, it sounds like you did, which for me, I didn't even know about the World Cup until I was 14, so... Like around the 2014 World Cup was when that was the first World Cup I actually watched matches for. So it's interesting to see what people know and remember from those World Cups that experienced them at the time. Get the header on target. Close. Not bad, not bad though. Because for me, I missed a lot of those experiences that I could have had as a kid, just because where I was, there wasn't much exposure to him, which it's fine all in all that it is what it is. I think I watched it right when I needed to, but oh, he hit that in the bottom left corner. Because in high school, I started watching my first World Cups, I watched my first Premier League matches, and then eventually, like, oh, there's a team near me, in the States where I could watch games and see stuff. So that kind of grew my desire, and playing FIFA and eventually PES really, come on, stay front, stay front. There we go. Really helped grow that knowledge of what those were. I can't imagine how that was watching that live. Watching him headbutt Zidane. Good save. Good save, Huertas. Those moments are so just out of the blue, and you'll never see something like that. I would think you never see something like that again on a football pitch, and it's interesting to see people's thoughts on that. Yeah. Come on, Henri. There's always been rumors about what happened there, and obviously, I'll never know. No one will never know for sure, but it's always interesting to see what would make a player do such a thing at such a time, you know? Of course, there's been opinions galore on about the situation and what should have been done and what he did wrong and did right or whatever it may be. Just like with the Beckham kick and the, I think it was a 90, what cup was that, 94 World Cup? I think it was a 94 or a 98 World Cup. Like, all those moments are so overanalyzed. Okay, we're changing things up because, as you can see, my entire team's out of form, so I'm going to take Henri off and put in Trezeguet just because I need someone with fitness at the end of this game. Approaching the last 15 minutes of the game. He's cut the pass out beautifully. Okay. On Vieira. Okay, here we go. Is it done? Ribery. Come on. Okay. See if Trezeguet. Trying to get some, like, there. If I just had a little bit more time, I would have gotten the opportunity to play it through to Zidane, but. Let's try switching the ball. Let's get a click through to Malouda. Just not working. He said. Yeah, I can imagine that. I know because my national team would technically be the United States, and then I have some Irish heritage, so Irish, and then also Mexico somewhere mixed in there too. But obviously, the United States is the main one. But it's just, for me, it's with how poorly our team is done in terms of how they represent, and how do I phrase this? So basically, it feels like it's a mess a lot of times, the national team is for the United States, but that's probably true. I feel the same, people feel the same way about the English national team, and I would assume it's the same for a lot of people that feel strongly about the national team, is that it's just a mess. So a lot of times I don't really watch them too much. I spend a lot more close time watching club teams than I do national teams, which I feel is kind of normal in my area. you see a lot more people watch club teams and don't really pay attention to the national team as much. But let's see. Okay. Let's see if we can get... I'm fine with that. It's not a bad PK. But I can see how that would make it a lot more impactful. Especially first World Cup ever. Just being there would be an amazing accomplishment and an amazing period. I think it will be fun in this next World Cup because of the expanded format is a good thing, and the fact that you will see a lot more nations playing a lot a lot different teams. Whereas it gets pretty common, you see like the Netherlands is always around there, France, England has been typically been a good team, another great save at Barthez, has been a team that's been pretty high up in the finishing places lately, as everybody finishes it off to actually change history, if you say so. Zidane stays on, Ribery finishes off in PKs, and France wins the 2006 World Cup? Question mark. But yeah, so it'll be cool to see what teams are able to qualify. United States automatically gets in. Mexico automatically gets into, I'm pretty sure, and Canada. So there will be a ton of new, I would believe, at least a ton of new qualifiers for the CONCACAF, because you might see like Costa Rica, who I don't know if Navas will still be in goal for him at that time, but like Costa Rica, might have some smaller teams in the Caribbean that might end up getting through, but we'll have to see. It'll be interesting to see. But yeah, so I'm gonna end playing PES 6, and we're gonna see how this works. So bear with me. I'm gonna transition from playing PES 6 to play one of my PS2 titles. So we're gonna see how the stream does with that. So we're gonna close PES 6. And then it's gonna be looking for gameplay. So bear with me with that. We're gonna play FIFA 01 next. And see how it does. So let's see. Does it pick it up? Okay, there we go. So you should see FIFA 01 now. Let me know if it looks all right. And we'll go from there. Okay. I think the controller will work too. So we might have to bear with changing controller settings. Yeah, I'm gonna go quickly get a drink of water, and then we're gonna play a little of FIFA 1. Yep, good. Be right back, guys. Be right back. Okay, be right back. Okay, we are back. We are back. Take a quick swig. Let's see. So let's do. Actually, I'm not going to start it today because I would like to do a separate stream for that. But let's look at teams that we could do this with. So FIFA 01 doesn't have a set career mode. I don't think career mode came in FIFA until FIFA 05. I think it was when career mode came in. So they have tournament mode. They have season mode. I would have to do season. So let's see what season formats they have. I would like to do a main league because I think that'd be fun and see how it changes. They have Spain, Sweden, Austria. I won't do a smaller league. I want to do like a big one. Let's just play with some teams. Let's just play a game. Let's just play a game. I think I would probably do with the English league because I think that'd be the best. The Premier League. I think it'd be the most enjoyable one to do this type of thing with, change history with. So let's just pick a couple of teams from England. Let's pick Chelsea. Let's do Chelsea versus. I've never seen that Sunderland batch before. That is freaky. I do not like that badge. I guess I forgot to see what difficulty I put it at, so we might be in Smashed. I guess we'll see. This is the FIFA out of all the older ones, like FIFA 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I played the most because I was doing that recreation of history league. I don't know if I'd really. That series kind of died because I just lost time and I was in college. I am out of college now, but it kind of made that very difficult. But yes, you will probably hear the controller a lot more for this one, just for the sole fact that you have to tap the triangle button so bloody much. For sprint, because that's the only way you sprint in this game is by the triangle button. So it'll be very retro in that aspect. Let's play forward. Let's see, I know Desai. Do we know any other players in this team? Bluff sounds familiar. Graham Lasso, commentator now. Hasselbank, I recognize the name. Gianfranco Sola, I know. Johnson. So yeah, I know those. Zola must be getting up in age for him to be that low of a rating. Like this game, I would consider the foreign era compared to modern games now, just for the sole fact of the sprint button being what it is, a triangle, like a touchpad. And then R2 is a Maradona. So that's one thing that's already very different. And then L1 is like a through pass. This game also has very funny tackle animations. If you guys have seen my rewriting PES 1, I don't think you really would have seen it, but I did record some of the footage for it, and it was interesting, to say the least. Come on. There we go. Goal. Chelsea. But like I said, I have all these old PES and FIFA titles. I've always wanted to play this on that. PES would be so much harder to do this on, though, because if you go so far back, the older PES games... good goal. Brilliant goal. The older PES games, they don't have an actual league system. They only have a set amount of teams, and those teams don't have their correct licensing. So, I was playing, like I was saying earlier, I was playing Win 11 7, which is PES 3 technically, for the 02-03 season. Would that be really the 02? No, it would be the 03-04 season. And when I was playing that, United was Tradbrick. So, it really would have to be a situation where you are basically just changing the transfers for those top team. Bloody hell! I'm scoring the best goal I have on this game. I did nothing. But yeah, top teams, their transfers, that type of thing. Because, yeah, it only has those set of 20 teams, random teams. This game isn't, good volley, isn't bad. Would it be my first FIFA I would pick off the shelf? Even also considering that I am a PES person? No, it would not. But he just wasn't head. But it's still decent. Still a good option. I honestly enjoy this more than even the middle FIFAs, like FIFA 2003, because that's the third goal. Just because those FIFAs kind of feel weird. If I did play those, and you may see in this game at points where I am playing this through an emulator, so I don't know where the current I am playing this on emulator, that's what I was trying to say. So there may be times where it kind of looks a little janky. I have thought about playing these older ones through, because I have a capture card that would work with this, but I haven't set it up yet to get it working. Otherwise, I have thought about the idea of possibly doing games straight from the PS2, that sort of thing. But yeah, Andrew, you said you saw someone playing PES 6 with current rosters. I've seen that. I try to score my own goal for a second. I've seen that. It's called a Firebird is the patch name. I've tried it out. It does look really janky and bad at times. I don't know if it's just mine that I was using, because I swear the gameplay with people playing, it looks a lot better. See, Pascal Bain, good goal. Good save. That's why I just, if I want to use the current rosters, I just play the current games, because PES 6's gameplay, I enjoy it. You have to get used to it, though. You really do. Just because it's so foreign to the newer games. But that's kind of the thing, is thinking about it, is that those games are good and I enjoy them, but I think I get really tired of them really fast. And that's why I hop between eras of FIFA and PES so much. I get tired of the older ones for being kind of janky. I'll go and play PES 21. If I get tired of PES's style, but I still want to play with current rosters, I'll go play FC 24. And yeah, that's kind of how I've done things, and that's why I think doing a series across all the FIFAs would be so fun. I wish so badly. Oh my god, that was another great attempt at a bike. I wish so badly that there was an Eras game mode where you could play through. Like, now it didn't have to be necessarily since the 1980s, like it is in the, it is in 2K. Maybe just 2000s. 2000, you started a career mode in 2000, and you basically try to... Wow, that's our best goal I have ever scored on this game. Fair play, fair play. But yeah, I would say that would be what I would like to do eventually. Because I just love playing older games. It's as if I was born in a different era where I played retro games at the time and I have that itch again. Because just something about them, I get more excited about what they have and what they have available. Now, to be granted, there's a game that has excited me recently, but it isn't a sports game, about the same amount as this game has, or not this game specifically, but buying older games like this, and it was, it is Tekken 8. Because what that game offers is so enjoyable. That's five now. It's so enjoyable for me. The content, the little details in that game are just... they're not in the mold of modern games as much as... in terms of modern games, a lot of them will kind of suck... you dry all of your money and they have all the microtransactions. But that game has little details like... it has every soundtrack from every single Tekken game. Can you imagine if FIFA had every soundtrack from every FIFA in it? I'm no one. You know, that'd be interesting. This is Chelsea versus Sunderland, right? Yeah. Probably pick a harder team next time. Okay. Yeah, I've heard that a lot, that Tekken 3 is one of people's favorites. My first Tekken was this one, was Tekken 8. And it might be one of my favorite games I've played in a while, just because, I don't know, it's just, I love the soundtrack. I love that type of EDM, electronic, and even like the vibe it provides is just impeccable. I like it a lot. And then the gameplay is really fun. It's not like I'm a newcomer to fighting games and I can't play, because that's... I've played Mortal Kombat, and because I got the newest one, I've been playing that with people, and when I play that, I tend to, what's the word? Not struggle, but it's very difficult for me to get the combos down. I can sometimes get them, but a lot of times it's just not quite there for me. Whereas if I'm playing Tekken, the starting level is easier for me to understand the combos and get them down and work up to it. I thought about getting Tekken 3 because the local retro game store that I go to had it, but I was like, I don't really want to spend extra money for it. It was only $20, considering it's one of the better games. It was on the PS1. I was thinking I would just get them all on the PS1. Up for the, because Tekken 1, 2, and 3, and 4, I'm pretty sure on the PS1. Then 5 and 6. No, 4 might be on the PS2. And 5 is on the PS2, and 6 is on the PS3. But yeah, I've heard that a lot. Why was it so good to you? What stood out to you, if you remember? I know it's been a long time since that game came out. It came out in the 90s, but was it the soundtrack? Was it the gameplay? Was it the fighters and how they played? Another bike? Bloody hell! It's so easy to score bikes in this game. Because for me, what I love is in Tekken 8, I'm switching the soundtracks around because I'm trying to, you get kind of samey with the new one, you know? So I've been trying to play the older soundtracks, and I really love Tekken 1 soundtrack. I like it a lot, and it fits what I enjoy when playing fighting games and the background noise. And I play that soundtrack in front of my girlfriend, and she says it sounds like Mario music, which I can definitely hear that now. That's kind of funny, you know? But I enjoy it a lot. Yeah. I'm definitely, after this match, I'm gonna up the difficulty. I think I might have it on the lowest dot right now, because PCSX2, I think this is something, the alphabet soup of words, of letters with that. This is the emulator I'm using. So with that emulator, it always does updates. And so I did basically a fresh save for this one. Yeah, what I've loved so far about as I'm playing older, that was full power. What I've loved so much about the new Tekken is the gameplay. It's really fun. It's really addicting. And then the content with the story modes, the complete customization options with the game. I've made 3 or 4 skins for 3 different characters. And I love the lightheartedness of some characters, but also that you still have a serious story at the bottom of it, to where you can have fun with it, but there's still serious moments between Jin and, I never can say his name right, like Kazuya. And then June, his mother, and all that stuff. The only thing that sucks about the simulator is a lot of these older Pezzes, older FIFAs, don't really work correctly on the emulator. So if I was to do a stream, it would probably be on those older games. It'd probably need to be on the PS2, but that's okay. I could do that. Like, if you look at O, you see how he looked like a stick figure from the PS1 era? That's because of the emulator not being able to, since it's in 1080p, and it's, I swear they look like that on the PS, whew, what a goal. I swear they look like that on the PS2. We just can't see it because it's hiding all of it. As we look at the eFootball crowd. eFootball 24 crowd. Dear God, some of those images for that game at the very beginning when it came out were just... makes me wish they actually made a full-fledged PES game again, but probably won't happen.
Maybe the second half will change that if the manager does his job.
Okay, 4-0 at halftime. We're definitely changing this. Come on, that's a goal. 5-0. Four and nil.
The punishment continues here. 5-0 now, and really no sign of a miracle comeback, I'm afraid. Maldini.
Ah, 1 second. I set up my phone so I can't see what you guys are saying. There you go. Yeah, I get that. A lot of my games are like that, Andrew, where, like, with, like, FIFA 15 is a good example of a game that I got in high school and was my first FIFA 2, so it was that first experience of that freshness. And the newer ones just don't compare, even though I enjoy parts of them. And FIFA's a terrible example for that, because just what it is. I guess one would be Mario Kart. Mario Kart Double Dash, I played that a lot as a kid. I love that game. My girlfriend, she likes Mario Kart, and she has it on her Switch. But she does not like Mario Kart Double Dash at all. Comparatively. Damn. Come on. So, it's probably true. A lot of the games that you hold dear to you as a kid, and just the moments you get with those characters probably can't compare. But that's why Tekken 8 has been such a revelation to me, because I didn't think a game could be so special to me again, because I just haven't had that experience with games where I just get entrenched with it after a while. The last time I had one where I just had to keep playing was actually a football game. I got PES 2 last October, and so I got PES 2. And there's just a straight couple days where I played like 30 matches on that game, trying to get through a Master League, but I ended up stopped playing because it just got really frustrating, and I couldn't really get past out of my division, so I took a hiatus, and I'll probably go back to it eventually, but it's just fun when you get into those grooves with games, and you just get so addicted, too addicted where you can't do anything else, because I still am. I'm still playing football, and I'm still doing stuff with family and friends and with my girlfriend and everything, but it's such a unique experience, you know. It's like when I hear people talk about I hear people talk about when I watch stuff or see videos on the Atari, people that play the Atari, or they play like these games at the time, and they enjoyed them a lot, and they would play them all night, and it's just, I can't play this game all night. I'm just saying, I can't. It's all right, but it ain't that good. If you know what I mean. But I think it's more the fact that the reason I can't is just so many games for me just do more things. Now, could I even play FIFA 15 all night again? Probably not. Could I play some of the games I play as a kid? Like, could I play Lego Star Wars, the video game, all night? I probably still could. Could I play it all night as a kid? No. But could I now? Yeah, maybe. Or I played Age of Empires all the time as a kid. I played it with my cousins, I played it with my dad. I still do sometimes with all of them. I could play that one too. Yeah. Yeah, I imagine that would be that way with playing computer games. I was fortunate that, so my gaming history is kind of funny because I started on computer games, playing Rise of Nations, playing Age of Empires, and then I had a PS2 as well, around when I was 4 or 5, and I would play games, but I didn't really play sports games, so I had a basketball game. I had a, let's up the difficulty a little bit in transition to another one. But yeah, so I had, hell yeah, I was on amateur. So I had a PS2, but I had like a basketball game, a baseball game eventually. I didn't have any soccer games because I didn't know about them. I don't even know if I really knew where they were to buy in the United States. And so, let's do the Milan Derby. Let's do Inter versus AC Milan. I'll play AC this time. So, I would do, a lot of my gaming was on my computer and just playing with strategy games, so I got really big into history stuff, which I still enjoy history, but not as much because I'm big into very sports-related stuff now. But I understand that same feeling, but with Mario Kart Double Dash, because when I was a kid, I distinctly remember this party. I probably was about 4, 5, or 6, and I went to this party in, it was my mom's friend's party, so all my mom's friends were there, but they had kids there, and it was at this random house in the country, and they happened to have a GameCube system at the time, and so I swear, I played Double Dash the entire time I was at that party, and I think I ended up getting it right after that. Getting a GameCube because I loved it that much. And it was a really fun day. I just played Mario Kart Double Dash with all these kids. God, this is much harder. Okay, there we go. I forgot the amount of times I tackle in this game. That's kind of, I kind of missed out on all those things. As Shevchenko scores a bike against Internazionale. I missed out on all those things because I didn't get them later, but that's why I'm getting these now, so I can kind of experience it a little bit, even though it's not how it was at the time. I definitely feel that. And I don't know if you've had this. because I think you talked about playing FC24 on comment on another video, but I can't imagine the burnout you would feel. Yeah, Crash Team Racing on the PS1. Yeah, I never played that one because, again, my first console was a PS2, so a lot of my PS1 games I never played. I do remember, before I get back to the FIFA stuff, I do remember playing, they had a Disney one with a Shrek. Oh my god, he's splitting me apart. A Shrek racing game that I played that as a kid, and then there was a Super Bombad Racing was basically a Star Wars racing game too. Kart racing game, both those were like kart racing games. And they are not very good at all. But they're funny. They're funny to watch. Jesus. Bloody hell. But yeah, I was saying, I bet you would get FIFA fatigue after a while. I don't know if it was different with the older ones, because whenever I play the older ones, they seem like they change so much. Like, this compared to FIFA 02 is completely different on the PS2. But this game compared to, like, FIFA 15 compared to FIFA 16, it isn't that different. And especially FIFA 18 to 19 to 20, there isn't that much of a difference. Obviously, if you played the games, then you know there's a difference. But not enough to where you would think it's reasonable enough that they're on two different stratospheres of games, you know? Which is unfortunate. I wish it was different. I talked about sports games in a past video about the decline of them. And it's just frustrating because they can be so much more. They can be love letters to the sport that they're providing. They can be a realistic depiction of the sport, with arcadey. You can have an arcadey one. You can have a realistic depiction that provides a learning environment. Because it, for me, FIFA was a big step in me learning about teams and what they are, and it's kind of how I learned about Manchester United, which is one of my favorite clubs. And I learned about the teams in my area through the game, like all these things I wouldn't have had the opportunity to if I'd never played FIFA in the first place. And we learned about it. Yeah, that was the reverse compatibility thing that you're talking about is so important. That's why it kind of sucks that the PS4 and then the 5 still doesn't have a complete compatible library to the older stuff, you know? Like the Xbox has for the most part. Now, granted, it doesn't have sports games. All of EA's catalog of sports games, at least for FIFA's, as far as I'm aware, you cannot do reverse compatibility with, which is so infuriating for me that likes playing these older games. That's what I really want to do a lot of times, you know, and play on hardware where, not that I only can just record it in a better medium, but that I can play it in a better medium. And it's funny that it took so long for us to start seeing full compatibility lists with the PS5 and the PS4 being basically fully backwards compatible with each other. And the fact that it took the first gen 3 had backwards compatibility with the PS2 with some games. I don't think it had all of them. And then another bike. It's fine by Bitterhoff. It's kind of annoying that it took that long. Because I do remember having, I had PS2. I had the PS2, and I had PS1 games available as well. I had a Harry Potter game. I think it was like the Sorcerer's Stone. And then I had a couple kiddie games. I think there was Sesame Street. I remember that game and the sound effects for that game. They had like a sack race in that game. Ugh, that's funny. Got Maldini on the playing left back, I think. He has to be 30 at this point. Try to hit it to Trough. Nope. Okay. Stuck under my feet. Yeah, this is a lot closer game though. This is much better. I like scoring, but I like it to be competitive too, you know. But yeah, like I was saying, I think sports games could be much more. They could provide the classic teams, like 2K does, NBA 2K. It could provide the eras like 2K does. It could teach you about the sport, like MLB The Show 23 did a Negro Leagues moment. So it talks about the Negro Leagues and talked about certain players in the Negro Leagues, which I think this version, as I hit another bike, is going to do that as well. Yeah, I understand, Andrew. I understand the pain. Because I didn't even get those days. I've watched them a lot, obviously, because those are the glory days of the United. But for me, I started supporting them in the 14-15 season. And so that was the first time I ever watched them. And then I watched, like, the book. Yep, no problem, Andrew. I'll see ya. Thanks, and I'll, you'll probably hear the VOD if you come back through and, hear me talking, but thanks for coming. I appreciate it. I appreciate your support for the channel, too, and it's always nice to hear people talk about stuff and talk about these games and start building a community around them, you know. But thanks, I'll see ya. But yeah, I guess talking about United, I started watching United in the 14-15 season. And so when I was watching, they had just got Wayne Rooney, or not just got Wayne Rooney, duh. I haven't Rooney for a long time at that point. Wayne Rooney was one of their best hallmark players. Ron Van Persie was basically about to leave. And they finished like sixth that season. But yeah, it's difficult watching them sometimes this season and this year. These years. Okay, 1 second. So I think that'll actually be the last bit I will stream for tonight as well. Just because it's been 2 hours, I think it's a good time to stop. I think the next stream I will do will be a starting of streaming the Kuruma to Cross Generations. Doing it on, a stream across FIFA 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, all the way to FC 24. So expect that eventually. We'll do stuff like that. But yeah, so thank you for watching. All of you that joined, or if you're watching this video later, if you enjoyed this, please do return and come and watch the stream sometime. There'll probably be a set schedule at some point. Friday nights work pretty decently for me, at least a couple hours that day. And go from there. Thank you guys for watching. And welcome to the club. And I hope you stick around and enjoy what you see. So, see ya.